I want to thank everybody for the awesome comments I got in the last few weeks. You guys are the true MVPs, and because of you, this channel is on its way to 25k subscribers. The last few years I was fascinated with the way Japanese tanks were painted, and especially interesting eye catchers are the yellow stripes that were going down on the fronts and the sides of the tank. This made the Japanese tank look a bit unique. When I started building my first Japanese model kit, I wanted to make sure my camouflage was correct, and I found some paint guides, and it turned out a lot of them were all wrong. Also, I could not find one explanation on what the yellow camouflage stripes or these disruptive stripes were actually for. So that's why I wanted to do a short and simple explanation video on Japanese camouflage. After some looking around in books and on Google, it turns out to be pretty basic and straightforward, and the Japanese used four official camouflage schemes. The first camouflage that was used in China in the 1930s was the well-known four-color camouflage scheme. This had a base color of ordnance khaki, with painted on mahogany brown and dark olive green and some light sand color camouflage, and it comes with the yellow disruptive stripes. From 1940 until 1941 they used the three-tone camouflage and did not use the light sand color anymore. And after 1942 the yellow disruptive stripes were also dropped, and they only used the three color camouflage scheme with the greenish ordnance khaki. This also comes with the camouflage mahogany brown and the dark olive green. But even though the yellow disruptive lines were now discontinued, they still could be seen on the battlefield. This is because the Japanese never repainted their tanks, and they would only repaint their markings. All of these camo schemes are used by the army and not by the Imperial Japanese Navy. The Navy also had tanks and amphibious tanks like the Kami, and they would always have a navy green paint job or an ordnance khaki one. Most amphibious tanks weren't painted khaki at all, because the Navy saw them as vessels and not as tanks, so they would have painted them navy gray. But to come back to the yellow disruptive stripes, what was their purpose? Now, it was a simple camouflage to split the tank into two or four separate parts, depending from where you were looking at. This effect was done by the sun, because we all have seen the sun rays coming through the top of the trees right now. These rays would break up the tank from a distance, making it harder to spot. So when you are doing a scale model, these yellow lines are not to be applied as normal camouflage. They need to be applied as four separate lines, one going from the front to the back and the other going from side to side. And they always meet on top of the turret. So as you can see, Japanese camouflage is pretty straightforward. And most of the time you can use only three colors and a yellow line that goes down four ways, and you're golden with your model kit. I hope this explains enough, and I hope more people will pick up a Japanese model kit. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next video. So as you can see by this wonderful and extremely well done animation, you can see that the sun rays sort of break up the tank, and this sucks.
Yeah, that sucks. Just like you.
Adewa.